Hello children, how are you? Okay, let us start the question answers now. Of first lesson, that is the heavenly parasol. I hope you all understood the lesson and the story. So let me give you the question answers. So first question, you have to write in one or two sentences. So here he is asking to write in one or two sentences. Either it may be one sentence, it depends on the question. Example, what was the name of beautiful princess of Prajyotisha? Her name was Amrita Prabha. Amrita Prabha was the name of the princess Prajyotisha. Next we have, what was arranged? So what was arranged for her marriage? At the age of 18, there was Swayamvara. Swayamvara was arranged for her to choose her husband. So do you, I hope you all know the word Swayamvara. The word Swayamvara, it says, yes. So the girl has to choose the husbands. Now, who was Meghavahana? Meghavahana was the great grandson of former king of Kashmir. So he was the great grandson, Mari Mommaga. Grandson andre Mommaga, great grandson andre Mari Mommaga. Next, why did the priest cry out in surprise? So priest, why did he shout there? The parasol of Varuna and had it cast its shadow over Meghavahana. So the priest cried out in surprise. So he was very happy. Was surprised. He was very surprised to have the shadow of the parasol. What was the uniqueness of the parasol? So how was the parasol? The parasol would cast its shadow over a sovereign of the whole world and no one else. Who is very good and who is very famous or having a honest king or kings, kingmen. So the parasol was casting its shadow. Now, next one. Why did the ministers of the Kashmir court make an offer to Meghavahana to be their king? Yes, somebody please tell the answer. Why did the ministers of the Kashmir court make an offer to Meghavahana to be their king? Because the previous minister was devoted himself to a life of prayer. That means he wanted to become Swamiji or he wanted to be the king. So they were asking Meghavahana to be their king. The ministers were dissatisfied with the ruler. The king had devoted himself to a life of prayer and neglected the affairs of the kingdom. He was not interested in the kingdom and he wanted to pray the God. Next one, what was the law imposed? So what was the law done by Meghavahana in the kingdom? He said, no violence should be or no one should kill any living things. Meghavahana imposed a law against the killing of living beings. Okay. Now, yes, anybody please read the eighth question. Read the eighth question. Why did Meghavahana want to conquer the island of Lanka? Yes, why did he want to conquer the Lanka? Yes, she has given a right answer. Meghavahana wanted to conquer the island of Lanka and teach the demons the ways of peace. He wanted to teach them peace, not to kill any living beings. Okay. Now next one, ninth one, what did Meghavahana witness in the middle of a wood? So wood means forest, yes. So all know the words. These are the words you should remember for the next lessons also. So wood means here forest. Meghavahana saw some sort of human sacrifice on the steps of temple of Chandika. Meghavahana saw some sort of human sacrifice. So someone, the barbarian was killing his son. Yes, in the temple of Chandika. Like Durga Devi. Why did barbarian want to kill an innocent man? So why did he wanted to kill the innocent? The barbarian son was ill and dying. The barbarian wanted to kill the man in sacrifice so that the gods would be pleased to and save his son's life. So he thought that if I kill him, the goddess would save my son's life. So he was killing. Next one. What is the 11th question? Please read it. Yes, you. How did Meghavahana rescue both the victims and the barbarian's son? Once again, please read the question. Okay. So, how did Meghavahana rescue the barbarian's son? Meghavahana offered his body. He said that if you want to save your son, I am ready to give my life. That means you can kill me. Meghavahana offered his body in sacrifice to Chandrika to save the lives of the victim and the barbarian son. The man and even the son. So by giving his life, he said, if you want to kill somebody, you can kill me and you can save your son. Next one. Yes, you read it. You read the question now. Next question. Please read louder, no? Okay. What happened when Meghavahana was about to strike himself? When Meghavahana was to cut his neck, what happened? As Meghavahana was about to strike himself, his head was covered. His head was covered with divine flowers of exquisite color and perfume. Someone held back his arm from killing himself. So when he bent at the time, somebody came and they hold his hand. Okay, next one. So I'm giving you some additional questions which are not in your reader. Who came to the Swayamvara of Amrita Prabha? Many illustrious suitors came to the Swayamvara of Princess Amrita Prabha. Why did many illustrious suitors assemble in Prajyotisha? So they wanted to become their wives. The suitors had heard tales of Amrita Prabha's beauty. They heard that, Amrita Prabha is so beautiful. So they wanted to see her and marry her. What was Meghavahana's ambition? His ambition was to not have any killing or no one should kill living beings and have peace everywhere. Where did the plaintive call that Meghavahana came from? It came from nearby wood or from the forest. So next one, you have the questions. Read them and write your own words. Write down these all questions. So if you are perfect with the lesson, then you can write the question answers, or else you feel difficulty. No necessary of by hearting the question answers. Read the question twice or thrice and then give the answers in your own words. No necessary of by hearting. So now you have some. Read the following statements and answer the questions given below. It casts its shade on none else but a sovereign of the whole world. Okay. Who said this? The king of Prajyotisha said this. Who was it said to? It was said to Meghavahana. And then when was it said? When they both got married. When the parasol of Varuna appeared beside Meghavahana and cast its shadow over him. Okay. Now the second one. You wretch, you dare to threaten another's life in my reign? Who said this? Meghavahana said this. To whom? To the barbarian. And when? When the barbarian was to kill a man to save his son's life. Now fill in the missing letters. No, one more you have. No. Okay. So he said, if you can't bring yourself to strike at me, I will use my own sword for the purpose. When the Meghavahana said to barbarian, the barbarian said, no, I can't kill you. So at that time, Meghavahana said this. If you can't bring yourself to strike at me, then that means if you are not ready to kill me, So let me kill myself and save your son's life. Who was the listener? The barbarian was the listener. What meaning does this sentence convey? The king asked the barbarian to kill him in sacrifice. The barbarian refused to do so. Refused means he rejected, or he didn't. He said that no, I can't kill you. Then the king said that he would kill himself with his own sword. Now you have fill the missing letters in the adjectives. So what do you know mean by adjectives? Yes, right. So anybody tell me the definition of adjective? Okay, so adjectives means how the he, she, or anything is. Things, how the things are. Here the first one is the character of a person who gets angry very fast. So who gets very angry very fast? No. For them we call as he is short-tempered. Short-tempered means he gets angry very soon, very fast. Now this first one. The word is the character of a person who always remains calm and poised. So the answer is composed. The word is composed. Next, second one, the character of a person who is concerned too much with his own needs or wishes. He's called as, yes, anybody? Yes, you tell the answer. Yes, right. Selfish. He's called as selfish. The person who wanted to do everything only for him is called as selfish. Next one, the character of a person which is compared to a fox. That is cunning, kutantra prani. Nari engirutte yavatlu yavaglu tan baggene yochane madutirutte yenadru profit aagbekandre tan baggene yochane madutte mattobra bagge yavattu yochane madalla. That is called as cunning, cunning. Next one, the character of a person who is careful and precise in everything is called as meticulous. Okay, so the person who is careful and precise in everything, yavudanna short agi martane amale kaaljeyinda martane, he is called as meticulous. Next one, the character of a person who exhibits very strong emotions or intense enthusiasm for something is called as passionate. A person who exhibits very strong emotions, that means yen bekkadagli na maade martini adu nim passion. Ratri eddunu odbodu, nasagnag odbodu, elladru busne hogtaro hogtiri athva garden ge hogtiri, terrace mele odu hogtiri. So that is a passion. And some students are there who like drawing. Wherever he sits, whenever he sits, he always draws. Singers, dancers, and some people who are good in cooking, they always try new dishes. Those are called as passionate. Some children are good in dancing, then cooking and all. Okay. Yes. So here we are finishing our lesson, and remaining parts do them by your own. In the next class we are going to discuss the second lesson, that is the boy who sold wisdom. So before starting the lesson, please read the lesson again and again. Don't listen the class or don't watch the class without reading the lesson. Okay? Have a nice day, have a great day, and complete all the question answers neatly. You have marks for writing neatly. Okay? Thank you.